Hello and welcome, I'm Raghav, and today I'm going to show you a very simple way to find XPath or other locators of an element on a browser. So yesterday I created a video on Escrie, which was how to use Escrie, which is a browser extension, to create and generate XPath and CSS path. And there's another very simple way I thought of sharing it with you. So you can go to any of your websites, and when you do a right click on any element or object and go to inspect, we have this developer console and we see the DOM of the web page where this particular area which is for that element is highlighted. And you can also get this if you press F12, you will get this developer console. And when you just do right click inspect, you will get here. And now here on this developer console, we are on the elements tab. If you do a right click here, and you can go to copy, and here you can see we have options to copy selector, copy JS path, and copy XPath. So I can click on copy XPath, which will copy the XPath for this Google search box, and then I can paste it here. Similarly, for this Google search button, I will do a right click, inspect, and then from here, I will do a right click and say copy, and I will say copy XPath. In case you want to get the selector or JS path, that will also work. I will copy XPath and I will use it here. Now you can see the XPath we are getting here is a little different than what we got with Escrie that we used yesterday, but still this will work. So one of the things you can do is you can copy this and go back to your browser here, and you can see my developer mode or developer console is still open. And now here with your developer console open, press Ctrl F on your keyboard or Command F if you are on Mac. So once you press Ctrl F or Command F, you will have this text box here, which is find string selector or XPath. You can put your XPath here and you can check if it is getting a unique count. So you should be getting something like this here, 1 of 1. So that means it is fetching a unique value or a unique element. And you can also edit your XPath here and you can test it here. So I can say like input, and you can see now this is finding 8 elements or 8 objects by the type input on this page. Then I can further say at name equals to Q, because I know the name attribute for the search box on Google is Q. So I'm saying name equals Q, and now you can see it is able to find a single object, and also if you see it is highlighted here and on the web page here. So this is a very simple way. I just thought of sharing it with you. I hope this is helpful. Thank you for watching.